Good afternoon, dear children. How are you all? You all are excellent and safe at home. Yes. Today, we'll see the next chapter, that is lesson number 9 and 10. Okay, na? Now we will see lesson number 9 and 10, that is together. Which lessons are that? That is in the tenses part only, continuous tense and perfect tenses. These two lessons, continuous tense and the perfect tense, lesson number 9 and lesson number 10. No, sorry, lesson number 10 and 11. 9 we have seen that simple tenses. Now lesson number 10 is continuous tense and the 11 is perfect tense. These two lessons that I will take together and see. Okay, now we'll see continuous tense first. Continuous tense, the present, now as I said, present tense, then simple present tense, simple continuous tense, then the perfect tense and past perfect tense, present perfect tense, in this way, that is sub part, that four sub parts are there that we are saying. Now this is a continuous tense we'll see, and then the perfect and the perfect continuous tense is also there. Okay, so this we will see the continuous tense. Okay, so what is the present continuous tense? Present continuous tense, an action which is currently or presently going on. As I said, continuous tense means with the verb ing form is there. Now what is continuous? Madam, I am teaching you, that is continuous tense. My work is going on, it's presently going on, that is called a present continuous tense. Okay, now I am teaching you, that is presently, at present I am teaching you, and my work is going on and on, that is called present continuous tense. So an action which is currently or presently going on is called present continuous tense. Okay, so in that present continuous tense, we are seeing that we are now, what is the structure of this S, subject plus is, am, are. Subject plus, in future, in singular, we always write is, am with the first pronoun I, first person I, am, we always write, and are for the plural. So subject plus is, am, are plus V1 plus ing. Continuous tense means ing is there. So ing plus object plus object. So how it will be? The example, we are studying English grammar. We are studying English grammar. So see, we a subject, is, am, are is there, V1 form, V1 plus ing means what is there? Study plus ing means studying. A study is there, study, S-T-U-D-Y, study plus ing, that is V1 plus ing form, studying English grammar. Okay, now the second example is, Ria is learning to play the guitar. Ria is learning is again subject, plus is, am, are, is there, V1 plus ing, learn, L-E-A-R, learn, ing, learning to play the guitar. This is present continuous tense, that an action which is presently or currently going on. Now, past continuous tense. Present is going on, past little bit backside. Okay, what is that? The past action, that an action which began in the past. Jo cheez kuch der pehle wo chalu ho gayi thi, but still going on, but still going on. Okay, that is called a past continuous tense. How you will come to know that is a past continuous tense? Past continuous tense, see here, was and were. ing, jahan bhi kahin ing lagta hai, that is a continuous tense. But you have to see is, am, are always come in the present. was, were, is always come in the past tense. Will and the shall always come, will be, shall be, will come, always come in the future tense. So in that way you must understand that, yes, now is, am, are, ing is there, present continuous tense. Was, were is there plus ing is there, past continuous there. And there, what is there here? Will be, ing is there, means that is a future continuous is there. Okay, so in this way it's very easy to understand the continuous tense. Okay, now I repeat. An action which began in the past and was still going on and until some other action happened. Kuch der pehle chalu ho gayi thi, now thi, but still going on, that is called a past continuous tense. So S subject plus was, were plus V1 form plus ing plus object. What is the example? I was taking, see, subject is here. Okay, was, were, are is there, take, T-A-K-E, take, this is the base form, we have added ing means taking, okay, this is added, we have added here, ing means taking a bath, I was taking a bath when the bell rang, when the bell rang, that is past continuous tense. What is the second example? When I reached the restaurant, reached the restaurant, they were means here is were and this is a argue, argue plus ing, argue is a verb, arguing, when they were arguing. These are the two examples of past continuous tense. We'll go to next, that is future continuous tense. Future continuous tense is an action which will begin. Action which will begin, chalu hoga, will begin in the future and will still go on until some other action will happen. Will go on. Abhi chalu nahi hua, magar chalu hoga, that is future tense. So what is the structure of that? Subject plus will be plus V1 form, that is a base form, and ing plus ing plus object. I repeat, subject plus will be form plus V1 form plus ing plus O. Okay, so that is I will be studying. So here I is a subject, we have written will be, C plus plus study is a main plus ing is here plus ing for my exam when Raju arrives. Okay, now the second is that this time next year I will be flying to London. Jo cheez ho chuki nahi hai mar hone wali hai. This time next year, agle saal ye samay pe main to London ja rahi hungi. Understand? So wo ho nahi hai but hone wali hai. So that is future continuous tense. I repeat this, whenever is, am, are plus ing is there, present continuous tense. Whenever was, were plus ing form is there, that is past continuous tense. And whenever will be plus V1 and ing form is there, that is a future continuous tense is there. Now we'll see that here, now we have seen the continuous tense. Now we'll go to perfect tenses. Okay, now we will go to perfect tenses. We'll see a second, that is present perfect tense. Okay, continuous tense we have just now we have seen. Now we'll see perfect tenses, that in that we'll see present perfect tense. Present perfect tense means what? An action began in the past or that action extends to the present. Present perfect tense jo ki hai, an action began in the past or that action extends to the present also, that is called. See what is the structure of that? S perfect tense, whenever perfect tense comes, there will be have or has in the present tense. Have or has will be there, have for plural, has for singular, their perfect tense. And here past tense have or has ka past tense kya hai? Had. So had will be there in the past tense, and in the future tense have will have. Okay, so now see the present perfect tense. Whenever perfect tense is there, have, has, had, they will be there. Okay, so now structure is S, subject plus have, has, V3 form will come plus object. Come to the example. I have read grammar book. I have read grammar book. Maine grammar book pad liya. I have, that is have means present tense. Had read, 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 read. The spelling will be same. Read, read, read. Like this will be there. Read, read, read. Means all the three form V1, V2, V3 will be read, read. Means the pronunciation is different. Read, read, read. Spelling is the same only. Okay. So what is there? I have read grammar book. Present perfect tense. She has worked in the school for 10 years. She has worked in the school for 10 years. What is that? Action is still going on. She has worked 10 years, but now also she is there teaching in the school. Okay. So how you will come to know that is the present tense? Because of this has. Has and have always come in the present tense, and because of this V3 form is there. So perfect tense means present perfect tense. Okay. Still is action is going on. Now past perfect, present, past, past, little bit. Okay, an action that occurred before another action in the past, before another action in the past. That is a present, past perfect, an action that occurred before another action, before another action in the past. Okay, what will be there? Instead of this have and has, there will be had. For the singular also, for the plural also, we always use had. So, S subject plus had plus V3 plus object. Now, I had played football before you come. Tum aane se pehle hi maine football khela. Okay, I had played. So, by the time I woke up, mother had completed. So that is past perfect tense. Past tense and the perfect tense, that is had completed all the work. You have to keep these structures in your mind. Okay, this no need to learn, just remind that what is there, the structure. No need to learn. So in the past perfect tense, S plus had plus V3 plus object. Now the future perfect tense. The future perfect tense, an action will occur before another action in the future. I repeat, an action will occur before another action in future. That is structure will be S plus will have. Future perfect will have plus V3 plus object. Will have. Wherever have, that is a perfect. Has, have, had, perfect. Okay. So, will means future. Future perfect. Very easy to recognize and understand also. What is the example? By next April, I will have gone to class 7th. Next April ta, main to 7th mein ja chuka rahunga. Gaye ne, still you are here, but still, you know, future perfect tense, mein pakka jaunga. So next exam, second example, by the time I will have been in UK for 6 months. Will have. So future perfect tense. Now in short, I have written this table, tense table, to understand what we have learned in the lesson number 9, 10 and 11. Short summary, all these things is there in the table. What is there? See the tense table, present, past, future, sub, four sub parts are there. Simple present tense, simple past tense, simple future tense. present continuous, past continuous, future continuous tense, present perfect tense, past perfect tense, future perfect tense, present perfect continuous tense, past perfect continuous tense, future perfect continuous tense. So if you will read this table, you will come to know what, which verb will be there. After that, you know, see all the key, write all the structures, this structure in the notebook, and accordingly see this, you will come to know the whole idea of this lessons what I taught you. See here, simple present tense, she goes. Simple past tense, V2 form, she went. And future, she will go. What is that? Present continuous tense, she is going. Past, she was going. Future, she will be going. Now, present perfect tense, she has gone. Structure, you have to see the structure, dear children. Past perfect, she had gone. Future perfect, she will have gone. She will have gone. Then the present perfect continuous tense, present perfect continuous, she has been going. Past perfect continuous tense, she had been going. Future perfect continuous tense, she will have been going. So dear children, all these tenses is very important. I hope dear children, you might have understood complete lesson. You need the revision for this lesson. If you are not getting, see whenever you need, open the video, see the video, try to understand this lesson and the lesson which they have given in the textbook, solve that all the exercise. Thank you and have a nice day.